Ah, running a business. It's so much fun because you can do so many different things. Each and every day looks different. But honestly, we have to do many different things, right? We have to wear 15 different hats each and every day. But today, we have artificial intelligence and we can replace that with 15 different chats. You know the value of having a coach. You know the value of being a mastermind. But honestly, today we can build that because like, a mastermind, you don't have that 24/7. A coach, you don't have it 24/7. So what if you could actually have that right here on your computer? That is what we're building today in 3 steps with ChatGPT. And all along the way, I'll show you a bunch of things you need to know to get the most out of ChatGPT. Because honestly, it's very simple to do something, but it's very difficult to get the good results. So are you ready? Let's go. In the first step, we're gonna figure out what our board of advisors will look like. Like, what kind of people do you want to have in there? If you already have a good idea of that, this is a great time to write it down. Another way to do it is literally ask ChatGPT to do it for you. That's exactly what I've done in this example. So I told it like, hey, ChatGPT, I need your creative and intelligent input. Here's the first ChatGPT pro tip, ding, ding, ding. Tell it to be creative and intelligent. Like, it makes a difference. ChatGPT is trained on the entirety of the internet. So by itself, it doesn't really have a very good clue of what kind of information it should give to you, right? Because the internet is full of great things, but it's also full of shit. So like, just tell them that you want to have the good things. Okay, so I want this to be creative and intelligent, and I'm describing what I'm doing. I'm running a small business, providing education and consulting for AI and automation. Hey guys, you're here, welcome. Specifically for small business owners, entrepreneurs, and solopreneurs. And then I talk about, okay, self-improvement and great mentors. And then I listed out a bunch of people that I love and admire and I think have great advice and I love listening to. So I'm building my own advisory board. So this is a bit background information. Now we're going into the goal. Like, this is a very good structure to follow to have your prompt in ChatGPT. Background information, the goal. And then we'll continue with the rest things, right? I'm building my AI advisory board. This is what it is. They have their own perspective, background, etc., etc. Okay, and now we're going to ask 2 things. So you might be thinking, okay, we just ask for this board of advisors. What does it look like? No, no, no. Second pro tip, ChatGPT. Ding, 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 ding. We want to provide the strategy of how to think about solving a problem. ChatGPT doesn't have this capability of thinking and reasoning like we humans do. When we answer a question, we first think in our mind, how do I answer this question? And then we go into it. ChatGPT doesn't have this internal process, but what it can do is it can write out thinking out loud, and then it sort of seems to behave a lot better. We call this chain of thought reasoning. It's been researched, there's papers about this stuff, but the clue of the point is you tell it how to think about it and you tell it to think out loud. That's why I have 2 steps here, because I want to tell it how does it create this board of advisors. And I want to do that by first, I tell it write down a summary of what makes the thought leaders I mentioned so good, inspiring, creative, unique, and I succinctly note their combined approach to life and business and why their advice would be so helpful. So I really wanted to go into and learn about these people, like, because it has information about all those people in its database, right? I wanted to pull that out and like tell me what is it about those people that is so important. That's the first step I tell it to do. And then after that, I want it to create my board of advisors. I want a list of people. I want it to come up with a name for them so it, like, it feels a bit more personal for me. And then I want it to describe their personality, expertise, perspective on life, and role models they represent. And then what I did at the end is I said format as if you're instructing each of them. For example, you are Jackson. You are a marketing blah, blah, blah. So that's how I tell it to format it. The reason I'm doing that is what we'll see in the second step. So let's look at the answer for now. All right. Well, it's a fantastic idea. Thank you, ChatGPT. I mean, I know, right? I know, but okay. So first it gives me the summary of the thought leaders. Honestly, I don't care about reading it. The content of this doesn't matter to me. What matters to me is the fact that this is training ChatGPT on how it should answer my actual question. And it needs to write it out loud to do a much better job at it. And here we have our AI advisory board. We have a list of 8 people, Samantha, Richard, Thomas, Evelyn, Maxwell, Olivia, Charlie, and Susan. And they all have a different approach to life. They all have a different perspective. They all have a different expertise. And now we can actually start talking to these people, because one of the key things about working with ChatGPT is that you want to give it a persona. And sometimes it's kind of difficult to come up with a persona. And sometimes, like, you have a persona one time that's really good, but you forgot about it later, right? So this is now a summary of a bunch of people who can help me specifically in my business and who are inspired by the people I already know and like and that I listen to online. So this is amazing. This is our step one. We built our AI advisory board. If you already know the kind of people that you want, if you say, like, I literally want Alex Hormozi to be in there, like, write that down, okay? Ask ChatGPT to give, like, a little prompt for describing Alex Hormozi, or just do it yourself, right? If you know him, it'll be kind of easy for you to describe Alex Hormozi. So let's move on to the second step, that is actually starting to use it. Step two, we're gonna make use of our advisory board and we're gonna actually have a conversation with them. Now, this is pretty easy. You just start a new chat in ChatGPT. And I said, like, imagine we are in a meeting where I, Marcel, I wanna say my name so that they know my name. Right? I'm talking with my AI advisory board about starting my business and making it a true success. The following are the descriptions of the member of the board. And this is literally copy paste from what we saw before, right? I'm giving it some information about my business. I'm also giving it some bit of background on the specific topic we're talking about right now. And this is some copy paste again from previous descriptions or notes I have in my notes. And then I said, okay, let's start with a round of advice based on this initial information. And then it goes through each of these people and gives them their perspective and their ideas on where I am and where I should be going. Like, I love this. Like, there's so many good points of advice here. Like, okay, Marcel, we need this customer journey. Like, my spiritual guide is saying, like, okay, ensure that it's, like, conscious with your clients, foster trust and harmony. The investment strategist is like, we need to invest, bro. The efficiency expert is like, we need to create systems because these 24 sessions, it's a lot, man, for your online program, right? Philosophical thinking, like, think about the why behind the thing because that's so important. And so we have all these amazing ideas. And I'm just kind of going through this and talking more about this. So I said, okay, thank you for this. Like, I'm kind of in a bit of a time crunch right now. Like, what would you do? Who would be the most important person to give me advice right now? This Evelyn efficiency expert is going into, I'm like going back and forth. I'm literally having the conversation with my advisory board and it's amazing. Like, what they're giving to me is incredible. And you can use this for so many different things. For example, if you're writing a proposal for a client, you throw it in there and you ask them to give advice. Like, what would my client think about this? What would their questions be? How can I make it better, right? Think about, like, what is my strategy? What should I focus on right now, given the constraints I have? Maybe you're traveling. Maybe you kind of don't know what you're doing. Maybe you want to try out different things. Maybe you want to branch out to a new social media platform. All those things, you can ask it to these people. Well, people, virtual people, right? We gave them a name, so you can say they're people, but yeah. And they will give you deep, insightful, practical advice because you're asking for it. Now, there's a catch here. The underlying technology, GPT-4, has a limited, what we call, context window. And the context window is the amount of text that kind of fits in the AI model. And it's what you need to know is about the input and output combined. And those two things combined are about like 10 book pages long. You can, of course, have a conversation in ChatGPT that's much longer than that. But underlying, the technical machinery will not be capable of handling that. Now, personally, I don't know exactly what they do with it. Maybe they only take the last part of the conversation, or maybe they just kind of like take the most important parts of the previous conversation to kind of like remind it. I'm not entirely sure. But what you will start to notice, if you have longer conversations in a single chat, you will see that it starts forgetting what it's talking about. One of the main ways you can get around this is by asking it to summarize once in a while what you've been talking about, so that kind of it's reminding itself. And another way we can do this is step three. In this third step, we're sort of getting around the problem of the context window, at least a little bit. And we're also being more precise in what kind of feedback and ideas we want. The way we do that is quite simple, by talking to individual coaches. Now, because we asked ChatGPT to format it as you are Samantha, whatever, we can just copy paste it into a new chat. And this is what I did now. So I took one of the points, one of the people in my advisory board, and I copy paste it. You are Samantha, a marketing maven, etc., etc. And the rest of this is the same thing I had in my description of the whole advisory board, right? And then I do dash dash dash, which is kind of a separator, helps ChatGPT like know, okay, this is the stop of one train of thought and the start of a new train of thought. And said, give your initial feedback and next steps. And then this is like, you see, this is a much, much more detailed piece of advice. It's not just like one or two sentences from each of the people, but it's very, very precise. I asked it for initial feedback and next steps. So you see like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is what you need to do right now. And this is great because like when you need to get into the weeds and start doing things, then it's really useful to have like a specific coach on a specific topic and getting into it. Now, one tip I want to give you here is organizing your tasks, because these conversations, they're not going to be like one or two things. You're going to keep doing them. Like Samantha, she's incredible. Like I want to keep talking to her. And so I like organizing it by having like a little emoji so I can very easily visually see who I'm talking to. Because like this, you know, these two chats, they're both about like the one is the entire group and the other one is this individual person, but it kind of titled it the same way. So I don't like that. So let's just change the name, find an emoji. So maybe a light bulb, and then we say Samantha, marketing, and AI accelerator, because that's the topic, right? And then for this collaborative one, let's maybe get like a group, and call this advisory board. So it's much more easier to find these things back because they will kind of reorder and reorganize. If you thought, wow, this is a great idea, and like you see how simple it is, this underscores the importance of continuing to learn about AI, because even like the most fundamental tool like ChatGPT, it has so much power inside of it, but you need to know how to use it. It's like, it's this blank text field problem. Like imagine there's a genie that pops up and it says, I can fulfill every wish, which is amazing, but you just don't know what to ask it. And you gotta be precise, because maybe you ask for like, oh, I wanna live forever, and then you get hit by a bus, you can't move your legs, can't move your arms, you're in the hospital, doctors are telling you all this, and you're sitting there, at least I'll live. Oh no, damn it, I'll live, right? Like, you have to be precise, you have to know what you want, you have to know what to ask, and asking good questions, honestly, that's a very difficult thing. Like, this is the main power of a good coach. They ask you the good questions. So I encourage you to please like continue learning about AI. On this YouTube channel, I'm continuing to make videos that are just free for you. I will also be hosting workshops that are free for you to join. And if you really want to dive in, if you really want to like automate and save a ton of time in your business, check out my AI Accelerator, which is a program where we will work on this stuff live. Like I will take you with me. I will teach you. I will show you what to do. We'll work on it together so that you have no fear of like being, oh, I'm not technical enough. I won't be able to follow this. Don't worry, we'll take care of all of that. You'll get inspired by the other people who are in the group. Like it's gonna be amazing. So check out the link in the description if you wanna join it. If you wanna see more content from me, make sure to like the video and click subscribe. That way YouTube knows this was good, I liked it, and it can help you improve your recommendation. So I will see you around and I hope you enjoyed this. Bye-bye.